Moment of truth. Moment of truth. I didn't lose any. Oh, fuck yes! Fuck yeah!
Yeah. If you want to fall over them, right? Yeah.
Why am I still getting most of these jobs? Fucking checked out. Lose any.
Oh, well, that's good.
Unless the changes after the storm, then I get fucked. I don't know.
You want to, what do you want to do then? You want to do some of this or you want to do some of that?
Well, I need money, so probably tow.
Okay.
Are you going to do this or are you going to do tow too? Because if you want to do this, then that's fine. I can just jump in with Veronica.
Yeah, I might actually do this, even though I need money, but I'll do it while I can, you know, to get.
You always take Arnie with you too.
True. Actually, I want to see what I got just for that one thing off of Old Mate.
Yeah, I should do the same. One.
Yeah, so it's like one per.
Run off then. I'll catch up with you later.
You guys need tires? Sounds good, man.
You guys need tires?
Nah, I'm all good. Thank you, though.
Oh, okay, I thought you guys needed tires.
What's that, Jordan?
Yeah, no worries, man. I'll talk to you soon.
Alright. Bye-bye.
Yo?
Guess what?
What?
I didn't lose any rep.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah. How long are you going to be tall for?
I wonder if that means... I don't know, not too much longer.
How long is not too much longer in degenerate?
Like 20 minutes, maybe? 30
That's
minutes?
It?
Yeah?
I was gonna jump in with you for a while.
I got 2 hours of sleep.
Well, what does that matter? You don't need sleep. You sleep when you're dead.
I'm dead.
You're dead?
Yeah.
Well, how do you want me to break that to Nick?
He's here.
Oh. He's awake too?
He just woke up. Just only the second.
For how long?
No idea. Oh. Probably not very long.
No, knowing him, it'll be for like 10 minutes, you know, because he hates me. Okay, well, I guess I do towing by myself then.
What happened to... Weren't you with Jordan?
No, he's going to do Mosley's.
Oh, okay.
Fuck, I forgot to check in. Well,
join the group, please.
Backing up, backing up.
I have tires. I bought tires.
Wait, where are you?
At the tot lot.
Good. I'm gonna yell at him.
Okay.
Hey, does he know anything about the thing that you told me about? You
does
ask
he
him?
Know anything about the thing that I told you about?
Which robbery.
Hey Nick, you know that people have been robbing the house up north?
Wait, where are you?
In the side lot. He only knows that the not HOA was robbed. We're in the main lot now?
I see.
Okay.
What? What? Actually trying to kill me?
Sorry.
Nick.
Sorry.
Nick. Nick.
Yeah.
I just did Mosley's.
Yeah.
And Tom doesn't hate me for it.
Really?
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah. So now I don't have to do tow all the time.
I've been hearing a couple of people say that you might be able to, like, you know, work a little bit here and there without Tom or whoever hating you. So I'm like,
Right here and there? Oh no.
Yeah, I heard somebody in there talking about grime the other day. And then I heard somebody at City Hall talking about, one of the other jobs.
Listen, I just want to break up my fucking day.
That's all.
Sick of doing fucking tow.
Be nice to have a little variety.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Maybe a little group six or something. Wait, so you did know about people getting robbed up there?
Well, they got robbed when we were there, you know?
Did they?
Yeah, that's what happened.
Oh, because Dahlia called and was like, apparently Nick already knows about this. I'm like, no, Nick would have called me if he had known about this.
It was when we were there. The cops were there.
I wasn't there.
You were there when you were upset. You were sitting. I saw cops in the background. They were looking close to the HOA, the Golden Bakery house.
Oh, you didn't mention anything.
No, because you were sad. I didn't want to make you madder.
Well, yeah, if people are getting robbed at the house, tell me, please.
Okay, sorry.
It's okay, but, like, that's even more reason to stay at the apartment.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, Dahlia called and told me about it after you went to bed. And I just figured you wouldn't have known because you would have called and told someone. Because I figured it happened after you dropped me off and then went up to bed.
Oh, no. It happened while we were there.
Do you have any, like, info about it?
What's that? Fair.
Do you have any info about it?
No. I only saw that there were a lot of cops around and... Well, technically, I guess it, like, I assumed, I didn't know. I haven't spoken to anyone about it.
Okay.
What Dahlia said was basically getting pressed and then, like, key taken or forced to open the door or something.
Huh?
Yeah.
Who did it?
No idea. she just said, does Nick have any information? And I was like, no, because I thought that you had gone to bed by this point, because she called me like an hour after you went to bed. And I was like, Nick would have called me if something had happened like that, because he's good with communication. And she was like, yeah, true.
What is your thoughts on auto turrets? Biometric ones.
The house into a rust base. No.
I just set a couple up around the corners of the house. It scans us and it knows us. Wait, I don't know. I always wear masks. I'd get shot. Fuck!
No rust base, please. It's a house.
You're also saying it's a house, but you forget that there was like there's a super terrorist living with us, so, you know.
There's two of them.
Well, one was deemed a super terrorist by the government.
And one was just so sneaky.
Yeah. And you got me, the mini terrorist. PD always called me a terrorist, not that I really did anything. I did do a fucking van bomb out the front of MRPD. Took out two cops.
Oh. I'd see four strapped to my chest once, tried to blow a bunch of people up. Does that count?
You know! Ah, fuck it, why not?
A terrorist, yay!
Well, I mean, you're also just, we also have several emotional terrorists living there too.
I am very much. Yeah.
And Dahlia.
Emotional terrorist.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, well, I'll let you guys get back to your shit. What are you sizing up to me for? What did I do?
I wasn't.
You're sizing me up? Huh?
No.
Have fun. Enjoy your date.
Bye-bye.
Bye. I think I've still got two tires left, right? I do. I am glad that I don't lose rep.
Oop, I'm killing myself in Minecraft.
Like, you're specifically going to go home to your computer and just log into Minecraft and die?
Even a fate worse than death, I'm going to have to go and work at Group 6 for 2 hours.
Well, then I want them.
Alright. Happy news. That's for the terrorists, right? Like explosive terrorists and emotional terrorists. Good shit. What a fucking life. I'm so glad I can do Mosley's. So the first one I went up like 3 rep. Yum. Yum. All right. God damn it. Why can't Brandon be awake? I'm not solo towing. Variety is great for people's sanity. I agree, because I don't even give a fuck that Mosley's pays fuck all. I care that I can do something fucking different and enjoy myself. Yes! Watch me check next storm and I will have lost fucking rep because of it. I wouldn't even know though because of the amount of towing I'll do. Alright, so... let's see who else is around at the moment. Ready up. Am I already ready? I haven't created a group. Create a group. Ready for jobs. Boom. Should get a job pretty quickly. That's not what I wanted. I wanted this. Gregor. Dom. Breakdown. Perez. Flying lock. Why does he want a lockpick? This is a dickhead saying buying lockpick and they're not answering. Alright, where's the job? Tongva. Oh, what a life. The frick are they beeping for? What the frick are they beeping for? If Mario's awake. All right.
Hi, Reggie.
Oh, you are awake.
Yeah, I am awake. What's up?
You don't call me anymore.
I've been having a lot of headaches today. I was gonna call you after my shift at the hospital.
What the fuck?
I'm gonna do call you. Hey, I'm at the hospital.
How are you like this to me? What did I do to you? What the fuck, Mari?
You know damn well what you fucking did. You mean?
Yeah, not do it again.
I have 7 packets of Tim Tams now, and it's too many. Because I was talking about this to other people, and now other people are buying me Tim Tams, and you'd think I'd love that, and I kind of do. And now I have too many Tim Tams.
Good. Just tell me when you run out, and then I'll give it a week, and then I'll remind you about Tim Tams again.
I'm not even going to get through 1 packet in a week. What are you talking about?
Oh, no, I said, tell me when you're done with them, and then I'll remind you in a week. I'm there, not meaning like...
Okay.
If you go through 7 packs of Tim Tams in a week, that's a problem.
I don't even think I can get through 1 pack of Tim Tam in a week.
Okay, well, I definitely can. Yeah.
I'll call you back in a little bit. I'm having a very important conversation about Sis and Aaron's love life right now.
Okay, that's a whole load of nope for me because they're fucking the stepbrother and sister. Goodbye. Okay. I don't want to know about that. Super fast train, you saw the day I saw a clip. Take a victim. It was like 5+ people. Too funny. Boom, 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 boom. Okay, mate, all done. Have a good day. Oh. Okay. I will never use that fucking elevator. I've seen too many people getting fucked up from it. Oh, impound. Say less. Money. Where is it? Say less. Money. I like money. That's true, chat. 4 subs away. 4 subs away, and then we're back at 600. Chat, do you want to see me happy? If so, check your primes. If you hate me, don't check your primes. That's okay too. You're entitled to hate me if you want. Not properly maintained. That elevator's a fucking death pit. Money. We drive to next impound for money. Oh. Fucking idiot almost got fucking killed. All of us hate you, that's why we're here every day. Okay. Yeah. Listen, you know, I'll take hate watches at the moment. It's okay. Hate watches are my bread and butter. Think of that. Fuck. I don't even know if he'll still be awake. Bloop. Bloop.
Bob DeGong.
Oh, you are awake still. How'd you go?
Yes. I haven't used it yet.
What?
I'm gonna use it today.
God damn it. I was so excited.
Don't worry. I'm gonna use it today, and I promise it'll be... Give me an hour. I'm gonna use it within the hour.
Okay. I wanna see it happen.
I'll take a photo for you.
Yes!
Don't worry.
Good.
I'll get petty. Give me an hour, I'll be petty.
Good. Hey, is Rhodes on duty?
He's not today, no.
Motherfucker. No, he's never on duty these days. Did that or he just dodges my calls? Okay, I guess he just dodges my calls. Thanks for ruining my day. Well, thank you.
I was gonna say he's usually on duty, but recently he's been getting on duty like later. I haven't seen him around in a couple days, to be honest.
I think he just hates me, Flop.
He doesn't hate you. Listen, if my own father doesn't respond to my text messages, don't take it personal.
Yeah, but you're easy to hate, Flop.
What the fuck? I'm hanging up this phone. Goddamn it.
Goodbye. Oh. Watch out. My eyes stopped twitching, please. Hello? Fuck. What is happening? I'm tweaking, chat. How can I still not see my own lights being on? No. Where are we going? Oh yes, perfect. Take that every day of the fucking week. You just get out of my way, white car.
Yo, okay, I'm free now.
Well, okay. Hello.
That's what you're doing.
There you go, mate.
Not doing much. What are you up to? You want to be sorry today?
I wasn't talking to you, Mario. Give me a second. I'll call you back. Hello, sorry, I was talking to you, but I think you might have thought I was talking on the phone.
We'll take care of it from here.
Alright, so that was just an impound that was park violation.
Okay, did you take a picture of it?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Okay, just to cover yourself.
Yeah. Appreciate it. You have a good day. Yep. I didn't really take a picture of it. Fuck, take a picture. That's not someone's car. Squid! Thank you. Back at 600. Thank you. I'm not hated. Someone doesn't hate me.
Yo.
Hello. Sorry, the guy at the impound lot was talking to me.
Yeah, you're good.
So, you want to hear something cool?
What's that?
I did two Mosley's jobs and I didn't lose any brownie points.
Really? Hell yeah, that seems good.
Yes. Can these fucking cars drive? Drive, it's a fucking green light! Fucking idiots.
Sounds like things are going well.
Yeah, yeah. They're going. What are you doing now?
Nothing. I'm just finished up. Just finished up at the hospital now.
Okay, well, apparently I have an impound to do at the hospital. There's no vehicles here.
In a sec, then.
I know there is. There's one vehicle.
Alright, I'll come out to you.
Alright. Goodbye.
Alright, bye-bye.
Hello. I gotta tell you this, some bitch. So what are you doing now?
I can do some toy with you. I'm just chilling.
Alright, yeah. I'll jump in. Jump on in.
Did the others update you on what happened to the house next door?
Yes. They didn't tell me exactly like any other details other than it happened. Do you know anything else?
Essentially, I know they know who did it.
Okay. What did they say?
Yeah, I think it was like Mr. K and a few others.
Okay.
And that they're not getting their, I don't know if they're going to get their shit back, to be honest. And essentially they've just been looking at houses that have been bought and just essentially waiting out front of them to see if they can catch anyone.
Okay. Right. Cool. Do you want to clock in?
Yes. Well, so today is a day that I'm having a lot of headaches, just FYI. Fun.
Oh, yeah. What a day for you. Hello.
Hello. Everything okay?
Yeah, she's just clocking on for the day. I'm taking this up to Polito.
Oh, God. Good luck on that trip.
Yeah, Tom hates me, I think. Tom's a bit of a wanker, though.
I mean, here's the problem. I don't think it's Tom's decision. I think it's like they have the records of where these people live, and they probably go to the garage that's close to where they live.
No, I think Tom just hates me.
I mean, that's obvious too. But I'm trying to give Tom some credit here.
No, I've punched him. One day I'll stab him.
Oh, don't worry. I think everybody's punched him at least once. Yeah. Good luck on the rest of your shift.
Same, man. So, what did they lose?
I don't know, I didn't ask, but a lot of stuff.
Sucks.
Like a lot.
Oh, what's up, Billy?
Hey, Reggie, how you doing? I finished talking to, Sonya and all them. Yeah. It was us. And just, I think, it's Red. It's Red down at the tow yard, right? I thought his name was Ren with an M.
Red.
Yeah, he was there when we all came rolling in with knives. It was actually like a group of a lot of us. So, yeah, okay. that was us the other day.
Right.
Yeah. Did you get a chance to talk to other guy, the business?
I don't think he's awake today, and I didn't get to see what everyone else thought of it. Yeah, so probably tomorrow. So you told him you're no longer doing blueprints? How'd they take that?
Well, you know, because I'm part of the organization, they took it personally. They said, well, how would you feel if, you know, in the future we get a blueprint for something you know, like a gun, and we just give an exclusive deal to somebody else and exclude you from that. So
I mean
they're not wrong, right?
It's not excluding them though, right? If they need a crowbar, you can still make them one.
Yeah, well, they want crowbars to push themselves now, apparently.
Maybe they should have thought about that before they decided to start flogging off the fucking blueprints.
That's what I said. You know, I said, well, this is originally what I wanted to do. We weren't in a position to do it, and you guys kind of pushed me into selling these blueprints, right?
Yeah.
And that's, I don't know. I mean, I just think they have a lot of issues with me right now, and you know, brought up a lot of things, and they're not entirely all wrong. You know, there's, I'm not being a team player with them, but in my eyes, we weren't in a position to take this on ourselves. And, you know, of course, yeah, the first few days are key. So,
yeah,
you know, they're impatient people. I'm a little more calculated. They're a little more rushed.
Yeah. Oh, I can tell.
So,
yeah.
Yeah. But it is what it is. You know, I sorted things out with them. But I did tell KJ that, you know, I'm not going to be giving blueprints to anybody else to push. So,
yeah,
I'm going to see if maybe, you know, he has an issue with a couple here and there. Maybe I get them off him at cost or at a reduced price and then allow them to flip it. But I just built this relationship with him. I don't, you know, I gave him my word that I wouldn't be giving the blueprints out to anybody else other than him and that other guy, right?
Yeah.
So, because I definitely don't want to break that.
It's going to end up putting like a direct competition, because they're going to be doing like approaching the same people as what he would be approaching. You get what I mean?
Yeah. No, 100%. That's not in my best interest and not in his best interest.
Because here's the thing, right? Is I understand that you're with them and that kind of shit, but it's wild that they wanted to fuck the market so quickly and started yellow paging people. Like, that's just the dumbest fucking thing I ever heard. And I had to smooth things over with Jordan so he wasn't going to fucking stab you. Because he had already worked out. It's you. You want to know how he worked out it was you?
How?
Because Mary told him.
Really?
Mary told him that you called her and offered her the blueprint.
Okay.
So you got to remember, a lot of people in the city talk about that shit, right?
Yeah.
So it is a very fucking dangerous game when it comes to that shit.
Well, I mean, this comes down to, like, well, who else did Mary tell? And, who else is Jordan going to tell, right?
Well, so it's not about who else is Jordan's going to tell, right? Because it's Mary told Jordan because they're close. Jordan found out because he's pissed, because he would have been looking at doing something with them, but not specifically with Mary, but he's pissed because of the whole Yellow Pages thing, right? Making a deal with someone, not an issue. Calling anyone and everyone off the fucking Yellow Pages, offering a fucking blueprint for a crowbar, big issue. Because then it just fucks the market then, right? Because now you're offering a 30 grand blueprint for something that's very cheap to make, and the person can make over fucking 80k with it after cost, right? Easily. Yeah. So that's a big issue in itself. Like he even said, I wouldn't have given a fuck if they charged like fucking 80 to 100k for the blueprint. That wouldn't have been like, that would have been like, cool, okay, they're keeping the market stable. But the fact that Sonya starts and Kirk starts calling people from the Yellow Pages, offering them to randos for 30 grand, then that means that like the personal buy-in for him is fuck all. So that's where he had the problem.
Yeah.
So it's why a lot of us operate in a very low-key kind of way, because it stops people from getting to other people, and it also stops people from getting fucked over. Because you'll work this out soon enough that even the change of a dollar in materials can cause someone to fucking shoot you. That's the kind of world that we live in, Billy.
I'm gathering that, yeah.
Yeah. So if you want to learn more about that world and how to be a little bit more discreet and get better connections, then KJ is definitely your guy for that.
100%. I don't want to be reckless and have people shoot me over simple basic things, you know. I wasn't around for any of today, really, you know, but I imagine there was some craziness in the crowbar market.
Oh, so many people have crowbars that they're trying to flog off right now. Like, there was even late last night, Ming was put out on Twitter, 4K for a crowbar.
Jesus.
Yeah.
How did Ming get a blueprint?
Fucks me. But
well, that either means someone else has it, or Vinny's scared there's competition and he's getting street sellers himself.
I would say definitely that there's other people with them now.
Yeah, probably.
So,
okay.
Yeah. That's why I said the 5K, right? Because chances are they might end up getting sold for like 6 to 7. It's whatever, right? You still get decent money out of it, and it keeps the game going, and it gives you that buffer room that if it has to go lower and it goes to the 5K, then that's fine. But it's fucking, can I fill this up? But it's I know it's going to be at 5K, right? That's where it's going to be.
You think about
that makes sense, yeah. That's kind of what I was figuring too. It's reasonable, right? Let me ask you something though. So part of me wants to go back to Sonya and just say, "Hey, told you so. This guy wants to stab me already," and Mary told him. She assured me Mary's not going to say anything. She's a business person. I said, Mary doesn't give a fuck who she got the blueprint one. Like, she's going to name drop like crazy.
Yep.
That's why I want to be anonymous. Don't?
No, I said, yep.
So, I mean, should I throw it in her face? Because that's sure what I want to do right now.
I mean, here's the thing, right? You do that, she goes back to Mary, complains at Mary. Mary complains to Jordan. Jordan complains to me. And it just starts this circle, right? All you need to do is literally just keep it. Like, hey, yo, this is what I'm doing. It's my blueprint. If you don't fucking like it, then that's fine. We deal with other shit as it comes.
So, Reggie.
Hmm.
That's going to turn me into an asshole, man. Think I should become an asshole? Think I should be like Brandon, like you?
Well, as long as you have a spine for it, Billy. Because at some point you got to put.
Will you teach me, Reggie?
I don't teach people like that shit. No, because I'm a sociopath, you dipshit. I'm a rare fucking breed in its own because I'm very aware. And I'm established
maybe
enough to know that people don't fuck with me.
You and I are more alike than you know.
Okay. See, the whole point of me being aware, right, is that I make it very well known to people of the shit that I fucking do if they fuck with me, right? You learnt that. And here's the thing. Can you sit there and say that you think that I won't do that to you if you try and fuck with me?
Define fuck with you. Like screw you over or just kind of like, you know,
yeah.
Kick the bear?
Screw me over.
I'm not going to screw you over, but you know, fuck around with you, have a good time. I hope
but
you
my know. My threat was real, right? You know that it's a credible threat.
Yeah.
That if you're
a sociopath, yeah.
If you fuck up with me, that I will fucking gut you, right? That's the difference.
But if I say that to someone, they're not going to believe it, right?
No. Holy fucking local, get out of my way.
All right, so here's what I got to do, man. I got to go out and I got to stab somebody and everybody needs to know about it.
No, that's not how it works.
That'll give me credibility.
It's a time thing, you dipshit.
All right.
It has to be more than just once.
So I got to stab multiple people.
Okay, that's not what I'm saying. You're not understanding. You're a dickhead.
All right, explain it.
Okay, so the reason people know that I don't fuck around with this shit is because they've seen it over many years and they've heard about it from other people, right? It's called reputation. Reputation isn't built instantly. Reputation is something that's built over time. So then people eventually work out, hey, maybe fucking with this guy is a very bad idea because he is going to fucking murder me. And not only that, I'm going to make your life a living fucking hell.
All right.
You're not wrong. So what you're saying is if I get screwed over with this blueprint thing from, you know, Mr. P, I should do something.
That's a little bit out of your grasp. You don't want to poke that bear.
Okay.
That bear has a lot more connections than you. So you need to look at this, right? Okay. As a risk analysis.
So, all right.
So you look at a risk. Have you done risk analysis before?
Yeah, you know what but that I don't is. Really know enough about people in the city to know, you know how well, I mean, he's
so then you well do, connected. You do your research. Like you ask people around you, i.e. asking me, asking Brandon. We tell you, hey, yo, dumb idea, don't do it. Right? Then you go, okay, well, that puts a very high on the fucking risk. Does it outweigh anything? No, it doesn't. So I'm not going to do that. But what I said to you originally with him was, if you get a kickback for it, cool. You do. If you don't, you expected that now, right? After being told.
Yeah.
And you just try and you just eat it, right? One of those things where you didn't know what you're doing. You got a little bit over your head. Shit happens, right? It's shit, but what can you do? Ask him for money if he tells you, no, I'm not making lockpicks. You're not getting your blueprint back. And you kind of just be like, okay, whatever. I just move on. I got fucked.
Yeah.
But in the future, you know, you look at it. Like, for example, KJ, when you met him, you know that motherfucker's going to gut you if you fuck with him, right?
I mean, honestly, he seemed like a nice dude, to be honest.
Yeah, like, but so you didn't get the vibe from him that he's probably going to fuck you up if you fuck with him kind of deal?
I mean, I know he will because he knows you, and you know, but if I just met him randomly, no.
Okay.
He didn't threaten me. He welcomed me in his home. He just seemed like
you know, you know why he did that though, right?
To create a nice trusting relationship.
Because I introduced you, right? Had I have not introduced you, then it would have been a whole complete different thing with him.
Okay.
So it's one of those things where he knows if I'm introducing him to someone that they know not to fuck around, right? So it's one of those things. So with Vinny and the deal you made with him, sure, ask him and see if he's got any money for you. If not, ask to see if you can buy out his half of the fucking blueprint. If he's not making them, then cool, you do your thing with it. If not, and he doesn't want to do that, just eat your L and move on.
Yeah.
All right, and then you work it in the future. If you got someone, a name you want to run by, myself or Brandon, you can do that. We'll both tell you and say whether or not it's a smart idea to fuck with them.
All right. Well, I mean, can you fuck with someone and then not know who it was? Like, say a month from now, you know, I just, just kidnap and torture the hell out of Vinny. You know, he's not going to know it was me if I'm wearing a mask and a disguise, right?
Surely.
And it's been such long enough time that he won't know.
I mean, you can hold on to that and do that. I mean, I used to do that all the time for targets that were bigger than me. That's because I was confident in myself running around solo when I needed to.
Yeah.
All comes down to that risk analysis, and you got to know if you get caught out, what's going to be coming for you, and whether or not it's worth it.
Yeah. No, you're right. You're right. I mean, if it's careful enough, then, you know, but obviously things happen. All right. What about Dex? You know the guy. Do you think I'm going to get that blueprint back?
No.
Okay. All right, yeah, that's kind of what I was thinking too. But yeah. It's weird because, my hang around for the families, which is, his OG crew, right? He's
You're a what?
I'm a GSF hang around.
What are you doing, Billy?
What do you mean?
Why?
I don't know. They were cool. I've been hanging out with them, you know.
Hey, Ma! Oh God. Okay.
Is that bad?
Do you usually throw yourself out of cars, Mari? Listen. Let me just run this one by it real quick, right?
But he wouldn't fall off a GSF hang around.
Let me just run this by it real quick, yeah. Right, Billy?
Yeah, sure.
Hey, Ma, I'm now a GSF hang around.
Yo, whatever you say.
So kind of sounds fucking dumb, right?
I mean, it does sound stupid, but yeah. You know, it's
why are you getting yourself involved in a gang, you dipshit?
Well, I'm just hanging around. I'm not in a gang. Like, I'm not colored.
That's
up
what a hang around is, you fuckhead. It starts getting involved in it.
Oh my God.
Okay. Well, you come and you hang around. You don't actually like stab fools. They're not going to call me up and be like, Billy, I need you here now.
Oh, fuck.
Like, okay. If a war comes down, like, I'm not involved in a war. That's family shit, right?
Oh, God. Billy, I just... Just give me a minute, Billy. Hold on.
You all right?
Yeah, we almost had a slight explosion.
Holy shit, okay. Yeah.
That's good. Okay, let's hope this doesn't blow up. Okay. That's what hangarounds do, though, right? Because you hang around, your idea is to get a part and be like a part of the gang. You dumbass. Right. You are not GSF material, you silly fuck.
I mean, they like me, you know, been hanging around.
Just because they're awake when you're awake doesn't give you enough reason, you dense cunt!
Well, I mean, they officially said I'm a hangaround.
Can you try and attach it, Mari, instead of lifting?
Why would a triple OG like Dex rip off a fucking hangaround?
Hold on. Is it attaching or no?
No.
Okay, so I need to push it. Mari, I need you to get ready to winch it. So cut the winch. Okay, and then get the winch ready. And when I tell you to winch it, winch it. Go. Okay. A little bit too slow. A little bit too slow there, Mari.
I don't know if you're on the boat or like...
No, if I tell you go, it means go for you.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yep.
Okay. When I tell you, go.
What are you doing right now, man?
Okay. Good shit. All right. Okay. It still didn't do it.
Are you having...
Okay, Billy, I'm calling you back.
No. Let me...
All right, Mari, I need you to do something separate, all right? When I tell you to lift the tray up, lift the tray up.
Yep. I broke my leg during all that.
Oh, God. What is this? Right. Apparently, it's still winched, but it's not. Can you see if you can cut the winch for me? Because I can't. Can you do it? You can, cool.
Yep.
All right. I'll yell out when to lift. All right, lift. Yeah. Good shit. Well done, Mari.
Let me get this straight. Billy.
Is a dipshit.
Is a GSF hang around? What the fuck?
Apparently.
It doesn't sound like he knows what that means.
What's up? You need to push it and then lift it at the same time.
Yeah.
Are you having a trouble?
Yeah, I think I'm having the same thing you did.
Give me a second, I'll help you.
Push it and lift at the same time?
Yeah, so get inside and I'll tell you when to lift it. All right, lift. A little bit slow, a little bit slow. Okay. You ready?
Yep.
Lift. Okay. Ow! Bah! Okay.
Oh,
all right, let me try again. All right, get ready. Get ready. Lift. Bah. Ow. You did it a little bit early on that one.
Oh my god.
Yeah, you definitely did it a little bit early. You fucked me up.
I'm gonna abandon this job.
Okay. I'd give you some bad.
Have you tried doing it from the front?
No, I'll give that a shot.
Yeah, try doing it from the front as well. Sometimes it works better. No worries. Let's go. Refresh and you shouldn't get it. Well, someone write to refresh. Thank you for the sub though.
Carmen, I'm just in a lot of pain right now.
That's all right, I'm in a lot of pain too.
So from the sounds of that phone call, he's a GSF hang around, but doesn't realize what hang around is entails. Am I hearing that right?
It's not like I'm in the gang. It's just like, that's exactly what a fucking hang around is for, you dipshit. Can we take a minute to talk about old mate back there where I tell him to fucking lift, he doesn't lift. And the next time I tell him to lift, he does it early and fucks me up. Like, I swear to God, some people.
Well,
but yes, Billy's an idiot.
The hangaround is literally the hangaround phase of a gang. It's where it's so the gang can gauge whether they want you and vice versa.
Yes.
It's a little bitch version. Like, you're like, yeah. Well, I'd say it's like almost, some gangs almost treat it like a little bitch kind of the gang. You know, you go through all the dirt and shit.
Yeah.
Getting into the gang.
Billy is not a fucking gang member.
Why GSF of all things, though?
Well, because they're around when he was around. And he thinks that they're good people. Fucks me, man. This guy's fucking fucked in the head. I can't believe it. He's supposed to be a clean guy, too, but he's a hang around for a gang?
Yeah, that.
I need to call him back and keep giving him shit about this. This guy's fucking lost it. He's off the fucking rocker.
Maybe he just likes the color green.
Okay, he's fucking on the phone.
People, he says, when they're literally G-checking, like I see them in the hospital, they G-check anyone who's wearing their color, and it's like, bruh.
Swear to God, the more I hear about Billy, the more I realize he's just a fuck up in life. This guy. I introduced him to KJ. KJ's now flipping crowbars for him. Mm. He's working with KJ for that. It's good for KJ and that. And plus, gives Billy the introduction to KJ.
Yeah.
But before that, the people that he was living in a house with, they were calling up people on the yellow pages selling blueprints for crowbars for 30 grand.
What?
Yeah. One of the people he lives in a house with is Sonia Summers.
Mm-hmm.
You know who that is?
The name sounds familiar, but I can't remember, to be honest.
She's like the Kiwi female version of Dundee.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Wow.
Okay. Yeah. So, you know, actually, Red KJ is nice, true. I don't know, man. Like, I pulled him out and got him to do a deal with KJ instead, where Billy gets, we've based it off them selling him at $5,000, right? Because that's what the market price will be. With everyone getting it, right? So, in doing that, Billy gets 1,750 per, right? Which is decent money when you can sell 25 of them off one blueprint. That's after all the cost and that kind of shit, right? So technically, they make $40,000 each, per blueprint. That's not bad, right? But it's just now she's pissed at him because he's not helping them and making them money. It's like, bruh.